Welcome back. The news in details. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi asserted that Egypt is looking forward to a Dabah nuclear plant as a new release added to achievements of the joint cooperation between Egypt and Russia throughout history. President al-Sisi's words came during his meeting on Monday with the director of the Russian Institution for Nuclear Energy, Rosatom, to follow up the progress report of a Dabah project for electricity generation. During the meeting, the president expressed confidence in the Russian expertise, which will be reflected through establishing the plant in accordance with the highest technical and technological efficiency, as well as nuclear safety standards. For his part, the Russian official stressed keenness on boosting cooperation between the institution and Egypt during the coming period. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi on Monday met with Presidential Advisor for Urban Planning General Amir Sayed Ahmed, Head of the Engineering Authority's Assistant for Projects, General Khaled Mubarak, Head of the Consultative Bureau of the Engineering Authority General Ashraf Al-Arabi, and Head of the Engineering Authority's Assistant for Road Designs Brigadier General Abdulaziz Al-Fi'i. Presidential spokesman Bassem Radi said that the meeting tackled the construction status of several projects implemented by the Engineering Authority throughout the country, especially in the new administrative capital, including headquarters of the Strategic Leadership, Egypt's International City for Olympic Games, International Horses City, and the International Station for Buses. The meeting also tackled the work rate of several construction national projects, especially Galata City and developing El Arish Port. Foreign Minister Sameh Shoukry held telephone talks with his Japanese counterpart Toshimitsu Motegi on means of boosting bilateral relations in all fields, in addition to a number of regional issues of mutual concern. The talks covered developments in construction work in the Grand Egyptian Museum, which is one of the most important examples of the Egyptian-Japanese cooperation. The two sides also exchanged views on means of curbing the spread of the coronavirus through cooperation between the two states. For his part, the Japanese minister expressed his country's keenness to enhance the Japanese-Arab dialogue, especially with Egypt heading the current session of the Arab League Council. Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces Lieutenant General Mohammed Farid inspected a training camp for qualifying fighters of the 2nd Field Army in Northern Sinai. The training is based on adopting the latest methods of combating in proportion to the nature of tasks they will be assigned to. Farid expressed appreciation for the efforts of the 2nd Field Army to preserve highest degrees of readiness and praised the success of the Armed Forces heroes in eliminating terrorist hideouts in Sinai Peninsula. Grand Mufti of Egypt Dr. Shawi Alem said on Monday that the Fatwa Authority plays a major role in unifying religious edicts. He said that Egypt can foil plots only through serious scientific achievements. The Grand Mufti was speaking during a press conference held at the Fatwa Authority headquarters to review achievements in 2020. The event was attended by a number of ministers, journalists, and public figures. He said that Dar al-Ifta tried to tackle the negative aspects in the society in its edicts. The Grand Mufti said that they had drawn a 5-year strategy. In his speech, Minister of Endowments Dr. Muhammad Mukhtar Guma called for vigilance to face all plots targeting the country. He expressed appreciation for the efforts of the Fatwa Authority. Meanwhile, Minister of Justice Councillor Omar Marwan said that Egypt is rich with many leading institutions, stressing on the important role played by the Fatwa Authority in uprooting extremism and terrorist groups. Egypt reported on Sunday 1,226 new coronavirus infections, bring the total number of cases to 132,541 people since the outbreak hit the country in mid-February. The Health Ministry also reported 53 new deaths, bringing the total number of fatalities to 7,405. The ministry added that the number of those who recovered and were discharged from hospitals rose to 110,015 people. Amid a rising number of coronavirus cases, the government banned all public festivities and gatherings as on the New Year's Eve.